Am I audible?
यस सर।
यस सर।
हाँ, इफ रिकॉर्डिंग स्टॉप्स कैन यू स्टार्ट रिकॉर्डिंग? नो अदर
श्योर सर।
स्टूडेंट? ओके, ओनली यू कैन
ओके सर।
रिकॉर्ड। नो, हाँ, नो अदर स्टूडेंट कैन स्टार्ट रिकॉर्डिंग एक्सेप्ट ऋषिकेश। ओके, बिकॉज आई ऑब्जर्व मेनी स्टूडेंट्स स्टार्टिंग रिकॉर्डिंग इन व्हाट्स सॉरी चैट बॉक्स, सो आई हैव द नेम्स ऑफ द स्टूडेंट्स ऑल्सो, बट they cannot complete a successful recording. If you see that they have completed only 1 minute or 2 minutes recording, this is not necessary. It is creating problem for other people who are recording it properly. If you see that, and it is hard, that is some students are trying to stop recording. Okay, which is this should not be the case. Okay, so right now, how many students join? Now 49 students join. It is already 11:30, so all students should join 5 minutes earlier to actual lecture time. That's why today I posted this link at least 1 hour before your session time. You see, am I audible? Hello.
Sir.
Yes, sir.
Still, how many students join? 56 students are there. If you see, so we'll not waste more time here. 58 students are there. Students, please join quickly. So I will wait for 1 more minute and we'll start our session. Now, am I audible?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay, good.
Yes, sir.
Because
I just
connected my mic here. That's why. Okay, good. And it is requested that nobody will start recording from student's end. Okay. Only I have given permission to one student for recording. If by mistake, if recording stops, then you can start recording. Okay, all are requested, please mute your audio and videos. It is making noise. Okay, till now 71 students joined only. 71. So now am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Now you are audible, sir.
Yeah, but means from beginning it was not audible.
Yes. No, yes, sir.
Then no, sir.
When
it stopped, I covered software project management, FTR, and software quality.
That nothing was audible, sir.
Okay. So anybody else? We miss all students did not listen that part.
Yes.
No, yes, sir.
Wrong starting, sir.
Okay, I will explain. Okay, I will explain now. Okay, no problem. Please mute your videos, audios. Okay, I will repeat. Because that is since last 10 minutes. Now, am I audible? Because I need to check
it.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Recording is in progress, Rishikesh. Yes. Recording is going on, no?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
No problem. Okay. Before this, I have taken the recap of the whatever topics we covered in last lecture. That is nothing but the seven core software engineering principles. We have taken quick recap of those principles, and after that, we have started the the software process framework, and we have discussed about the software process framework activities, and from software process framework umbrella activities. These are the set of activities which are necessary there, and why these umbrella these activities are called as umbrella activities, because like a umbrella that remains with you throughout the rainy season, like that these activities remain with software developer or engineer throughout the software development life cycle, if you see there. So first activity is here, that is a software project management. This is already discussed, but we need to discuss again here, if you see that. Because at every stage of your software development process, you have to assess the, the progress of your project development against the your project plan or against the project schedule. Okay, if it your project progress is lagging behind the schedule, you need to catch up the schedule by adding the more number of people or required or necessary resources. If you see there, if you are already added to schedule, then it is well and good, no problem. Okay, so you can give more emphasis in that case on the quality assurance, if you see there. Then a second umbrella activity is the FTR. This is also called as the formal technical reviews, and this meeting is conducted after every 8 days or the 15 days by the project manager, or the you can say the team leader also conducting such type of meetings there. And what is the ultimate goal of the FTR? It is nothing but the to assess software engineering work products. That may be the design model you can consider, or the you can say the particular module or part of module also, if you see there. And if any error there in that particular work product, then you need to remove those errors or fix that problem there only, so that it cannot proceed or pass on a next stage of your software development activity, if you see there. Then this is the formal technical reviews. Then software quality assurance. This is the next umbrella activity, and this is ultimate goal of the software quality assurance is nothing but the to assess the quality of your product till that particular point, if you see there, because we have already started the software development, and how much distance we have traveled as per your project schedule from beginning to that particular moment, if you see there, or point. So you have to assess the quality of that your software you can say the work product there. So in that case, you need to define, say, and conduct the set of activities and which are required to ensure the quality of your software, if you see there. So this will be the, again, continuous process there, software quality assurance. Then next umbrella activity is the software configuration management. Yeah, so this is also necessary in order to manage the change at every stage of your software development process, if you see there. So this is important umbrella activity, and this will remain throughout the software development process again. Change management, if you see there, or configuration management. So there is one special topic, one SCM, software configuration management. I think that is a part of unit number 4 or 5, if you see there. That time we'll see in detail this particular activity. Then next umbrella activity is work product preparation and production. Yes. So during the your software development process, that is at every stage you are producing one work product, and that may be reused for the next stage and so on, if you see there. So work product preparation and production means, if you see there, it involves you can consider one smaller help file or help document, if you see there, that can be considered, or you can say the model, that may be design model, or it can be the architecture or architectural model also. Then in terms of your software development, logs, then log file, or you can say the forms, because your application having the different types of form. So one form or collection of forms can be considered as a work product. So this is called as a work product preparation and production. Then preparing the list using the Excel sheet or the, can say the other, you can say the supporting software. So that is the part of the work product preparation and production. This is also the continuous process, because along with your software development, you are preparing the user manual. Then you can say the system manual and help to its user and customer. That also the part of, you can say the, work product preparation. Then reusability management. So we already seen that is the plan ahead for reuse. This is also the one software engineering principle out of the 7 core software engineering principles, if you see there, reusability management. So which components, or the, you can say the pattern that is reusable in your current software which you are developing there. So you have to make the plan that is ready with you, which components are available and which will be reused there. Okay, so you have to make the proper management of those reusability, that is the reusable components, if you see there, because there are huge or big risk also, because you are considering in advance that is the will be this collection of 10 components in our software project, but on time, that is the some components are not available, if you see there. In that case, so that will be the huge risk there. So you have to make the proper management of those reusable components also. Then measurement, if you see there, measurement is also the one of the important umbrella activity, and this is also the, you can say, continuous activity you are performing there, and which defines and collects project, process, and you can consider the product measures, and which are useful to their team and team members in deploying software or delivering the software which meets the customer's needs or requirements, if you see there. So this is also the one of the important, you can say, the umbrella activity, measurement. Okay. Then last one is the risk management. Okay. So as already discussed, so risk management This is also the one important activity there, because in unit number 4 or 5 we have again different types of risk and risk management and mitigation plan. Okay, that kind of topic is there. So in that you will study in detail risk management, because this is the important activity. So risk might be related to your manpower, or you can consider the related to the time, because if you are lagging behind schedule, okay, in that case that is the time related, or your budget is exceeding actual available estimated budget, that may be related to the finance related risk if you see there. So risk management, it assesses risk that may affect the outcome of the your project if you see there, and it may affect the quality of your software product if you see there. For that purpose this is the important umbrella activity. So there are total 7 umbrella activities. If question asked, it may be asked for 8 marks in NCM examination. So in that case you need to you can say state these 7 umbrella activities and explain in your own words. Okay, so any problem here? Am I audible?
Yes sir.
Okay, good. I'm just 107 students joined till now. Okay, then from the process framework itself, it contains the umbrella activities, then work task, work products, if you see there. Then we'll see the process pattern. So this is the important concept in software engineering, process patterns, if you see there. Process pattern, what is it? You can define process pattern also. So that is, it is nothing but the set of activities, then actions, work task, and work products, and or related behavior, that is called as a process pattern if you see there. And as far as process pattern is concerned, you should give the meaningful name to that process pattern if you see there. Means it should have the meaningful name, and then you have to mention their intent of pattern, for what purpose you are using that particular pattern there. So for that purpose, standard template is also available to define a pattern if you see there. So important point is here, you need to remember here, pattern should have the meaningful name, then you should clearly mention the intent of the pattern there. Okay, then typical examples of patterns are given here. Customer communication, it is also called as the process activity. So this is the communication pattern if you see there, and this is the name of the pattern, customer communication. What is the intent of this pattern? To collect the requirements from customer. Then second example is analysis, requirements analysis. This is an action pattern if you see there, or you can consider it as a requirements analysis. This is the one activity if you see there. This will be the pattern name. So here you are making in-depth analysis of the collected requirements. Those are collected from the customer or the user, and classifying those requirements. So in you can say the normal requirements and expected requirements categories if you see there. And miss you are identifying all requirements of your project during this particular pattern. Then next example, requirements gathering, a process task. This is also called as the process pattern, gathering the requirements. Then reviewing a work product, this is also again a process task. This is also the you can say the process pattern. Then design model, a work product, this may be the design pattern if you see that. So likewise you can give the different examples under process pattern if you see that. What is pattern, process pattern? You should know that one, because this is conducted for a particular purpose if you see there. And what it contains? It contains set of activities, actions, work tasks, work products, and that is the related behavior, if you see there. And you can use the standard template also to define a pattern. So this is all about the process pattern. Then next important topic we are going to start here, software process models, or just a process model in this slide. So whatever you can say, legacy models you are using, can say, or olden models you are using, or prescriptive process models, because the prescriptive process models follow the orderly software development approach, if you see there. So this definition is also given there. What is prescriptive process model? It follows the, or it advocate an orderly approach to software engineering for software development. Okay, and this orderly development leads to a few questions in your software engineer's mind or the developer's mind. That is, if prescriptive process model strive for structure and order, because it is the well structured, and development can be done in a particular order only, if you see there. That is the prescriptive process model. And are they inappropriate for a software world that thrives on change? So in case of the software world, who expect something changing process, software development process. So whether it will be adaptable for those people, that may be the question. And eight, if we reject traditional process model, means prescriptive process model, and it replaces them with something less structured. So that kind of model is available nowadays, that is like a agile software process model, if you see that. Okay, so this is the preliminary regarding the process model. What is prescriptive process model? We'll see examples of the prescriptive process model. Means you can say the, it can be classified into three different categories again, like the types of process model: linear, incremental, evolutionary process models. So as far as the linear software process model is concerned, well-known example is the, you can consider a waterfall model, if you see that. So this is the first process model we are going to study here. This diagram showing the waterfall model. Okay. So if you see there, it is having the same phases of software development lifecycle, or same you can say the five generic process framework activities, like communication, planning, modeling, construction, deployment. In communication, which set of activities are performed? Project initiation, requirement gathering. So you need to collect the all requirements, identify those requirements, and finalize those requirements as per your project scope, and clear objectives you need to set in this particular phase of the software development life cycle, if you see there, communication. Then after requirements are gathered, next phase is the planning. So you have to make the estimation, cost estimation or budget estimation of your project. Then we can estimate the time, that is how much time will require for your project. Then accordingly, you need to prepare the schedule. Schedule may be for the 1 year, two year duration. It depends on the type of project you are going to develop there, or size of project. Then there will be the continuous project tracking, software project management and tracking and control will be there. That plan will be, you can say, the decided in advance. How you can track the progress of your project, that will be the part of planning phase. Then after planning is ready, the next phase will be the modeling. So whatever requirements you have identified, you have to make the analysis model of those requirements. So during the modeling or analysis, you can say the model, you can consider the different types of elements, like the class-based elements, flow-oriented elements. Okay, then in case of the design model, also you can translate the your analysis model into its actual design model. Okay, during the design model, you can take the help of the different UML diagrams also there, like the use case diagram, class diagram, object diagram, then sequence diagram, activity diagram, state machine diagram, or you can say the deployment diagram or whatever, okay, or package diagram, most important diagram is there. So you can take the help of these kind of diagrams there, and from which you will understand the your project requirements in a better way, if you see there. And after everything is okay in modeling, itself, you have to decide and create the software architecture for your project, if you see there, type of architecture you are using. Then because architecture will represent the overall, you can say the interconnection of different components in your software, if you see there. Then from that model, and model will be considered as a blueprint of your software there, if you see there. And accordingly, you have to start, that is, the design will be translated into its actual coding there. So your software may contain one module or more than one module. So accordingly, you have to start working or start writing the source code. Okay, so, and simultaneously, unit testing will be conducted by the programmer or the developer itself, if you see there. And rest of testing will be conducted by the specialized software tester. And then it will be deployed to the customer or the end user. That is the delivery to the end user. And then as per customer's feedback, you need to provide the support or the maintenance support to the end user or the customer. Okay, so this is the continuous. But so waterfall model is the sequential model, if you see there. That is, you are deploying your software in a single, you can say, the increment. There are no more than one increment there, if you see there. And there are limitations to the customer also. That is, the they have to state all requirements in advance. They cannot, because requirements may not be adopted at later stages of development, if you see there. So they have to clearly state all requirements in advance before the initiating of your software project. So this is the, so if possible, students can, if you have a notebook or pages with you, you can draw these models while I am explaining from my side. Okay, that will be useful for you, because sometime question, this question is asked many times, if you see there. Explain the prescriptive process model, that is the waterfall model, with suitable diagram, and state its limitations, if you see there. So that kind of question is already asked in in-SEM examination as well as the end-SEM examination, if you see there. So again, we'll see the limitations of these or disadvantages of the waterfall model. And so in case of the real-time projects, rarely flow sequentially. So this model is will not become useful for the real-time projects, like the IoT related projects, if you see there. Then it is often difficult for the customer to state all the requirements at a time. Yeah. So in case of the waterfall model, as told earlier, the requirement should be well understood before beginning the project, you can say the implementation. So it will become very difficult for customers changing requirements. Means if customer that is a tail modification after beginning of software development, then it becomes the somewhat difficult task in case of the waterfall process model. Then a customer need to be tolerant, as the working model cannot be viewed unless last phase ends. So yeah, this is the also limitation or disadvantage, that is, the customer will not understand that is the working of that particular model, software model, until last phase comes there. Okay, if you see there, that is also the disadvantage. Then any mistake left untouched will not get discovered and corrected till last page. Yeah, So if any mistake remains there, which is not seen or remains untouched, if you see there, so that cannot be discovered or corrected until last phase of your software development life cycle. But because till that phase will not understand that mistake also there. So these are the disadvantages of the linear or the sequential model, waterfall model. Okay. Then if you have any query and questions, you can tell me in last 10 minutes. Okay. Then moving towards the next process model, that is the incremental model. So this is the somewhat you can say the modification here, and software will be released into different increments there, if you see that. And advantages of the incremental model will be here staffing get managed, whether you have less number of peoples or developers or human resources in that case, then delivery date is easily managed in this case. So accordingly you can recruit the number of peoples as per your requirement, whether you have earlier deadline or the late deadline for the project delivery in that case. Then resources are also managed in incremental model. So here resources are nothing but we'll consider hardware resources and human resources. Those will be easily managed here. So you can see this diagram showing the incremental software process model. Okay, so this diagram is actually shown in the form of graph. If you see there, software functionality and features versus project calendar time as per your schedule. Okay, so increment hash 1, then delivery of first increment. So increment hash 2, delivery of second increment, so on. Up to increment hash n, delivery of nth increment. So your software will be delivered into different increments, if you see that, not as in single increment like the waterfall process model. Okay, so if you see there, in increment hash 1, whatever requirements are available, they can start working on that. That is communication, again planning. Accordingly, you can make the planning and start working on that. And then modeling, analysis and design modeling. The next part will be that is the construction, coding and testing. Then final phase will be the, you can say the delivery of the software, maintenance, feedback. Okay, so likewise, these five generic process activities will be common. These are also called as the phases of software development life cycles. This will be common. Again, same process will be repeated for increment hash 2, increment hash 3, 4, 5, 6, up to n. Okay, so whatever requirements, that is the changing requirements are there, after increment hash 1, those will be adapted in increment hash 2. Okay, whatever remains from increment hash 2 may be adapted in increment hash 3, and so on, if you see there. So changing requirements will be easily adapted in this case, and software will be developed into different increments. So this is the incremental software process model. You can complete this diagram at home, no problem. Then next process model, RAD. So question on this one will be there, that is the explain with suitable diagram, that is the prescriptive process model, nothing but the incremental model. So you have to draw your diagram like this one, and you have to explain in your own words, and you have to state the advantages also here, if you see that. Okay, these advantages we already seen. Then next process model is the RAD process model, Rapid Application Development Process Model. Okay. So in case of the RAD process model, features or advantages are given here. You can develop, you can show the applications quickly. That is the rapid application development possible. Then In this case, communication and planning phases are common, if you see there. And during communication phase, you are understanding the business requirements from the customer or the current business, if you see there. And planning, accordingly, you have to make the planning. That is, the different teams will work in parallel on the, you can say, the modeling, construction, and testing phases, if you see there. So setup teams will work in parallel. So communication planning phase will be common. Then whatever you can say the you can say product that is developed by each team, that will be integrated, okay, after the testing phase, if you see there. So in that case, you need to conduct the integration testing also, if you see there. And what happens during the modeling, that analysis and design modeling, that is the data modeling, business modeling, and process modeling. This kind of task will be performed there, if you see there. Then construction, in RAD model, its name itself indicate rapid application development. That's why you are using the pre-existing software components and assembling those components, if you see there, during the construction or the implementation phase, okay, of your software development life cycle. So these are the you can say features of the rapid application development model. So now we can see the diagram that is showing the RAD model. You see there how this diagram is clear. Communication planning phases are common there. After that, modeling and construction phases are divided among the different teams. Team 1, 2, 3, 4, or nth team. Okay. And that is, individual team is working on one module, you can consider there. Okay. So different modules will be there. They are working modeling, means business modeling, data modeling, process modeling. This kind of task will be performed. And accordingly, you are preparing their analysis model and the design as per your project model, and you are creating the understanding the your project business requirement properly, and then you can start the constructing or implementation of that respective model using the available components. Okay, that is the component reuse and automatic code generation. And then we are testing those modules as a part of the unit testing or module testing purpose. Okay, if our modules are ready after testing from each individual teams, if you see there, team number 1, 2, 3, after construction and testing, those modules will be integrated, and integration testing will also be conducted. Okay, and then after integration, successful integration, that complete product as a whole, you can consider, that is delivered to the end user or the customer. Okay, so accordingly, the customer will accept your product, and if changes required by the customer, or if the customer or the user is facing some problem, then as per the customer's feedback, you have to make the changes in the next version of your software, if you see there. So these are the, you can say, the features of the rapid application development process model. And generally, duration of the development here, 60 to 90 days, that is the modeling and construction. It will not take more time. Okay, so applications which require to be developed quickly, okay, or if you have the that is the earlier deadline, project deadline, okay, in that case you can use this particular model. Okay, because you have to develop your project that is within 6 months, 7 months, if you see there, for such type of projects are smaller than those projects, you can use the this particular model, that is the RAD model. So what is time now? It is 12:20. So I think next we'll see the disadvantages of this RAD model, that is large team size required, then developer and customer should be committed because the deadline will be earlier in this case, and the requirements are already stated there. Then proper modeling is required, that may be related to business as per the changing business modeling, data modeling, whatever data you are going to process, then process modeling, whatever process you are adopting there. Then in this case, high performance software cannot be delivered. It requires to interface with system, because here you are using the ready-made components for reassembling the, for assembling your software product. And here again, high technical risk may be there because non-availability of reusable component. We have already seen this is also the one umbrella activity. Okay, that is, there should be proper component or reusable component management should be there. This also one umbrella activity, as well as one you can consider core software engineering principle, plan, adopt, reuse. So those components should be well available before beginning your software development, otherwise it will become a big risk. Okay, in next lecture we'll see the topics like the evolutionary process model, like spiral model, prototype model, specialized process model, and concurrent process model. Okay, so today we will stop here only, because today we have covered different topics like the umbrella activities from the process framework. Then after that we have seen the process pattern. After that we have started the software process model, that is the linear process model. We have seen waterfall model. Then after that we have started the incremental process model, right? Then after incremental process model we have seen the third process model, that is the RAD process model. Okay, and these three process models from prescriptive process model category we have covered today. So remaining model we will see in next lecture. If you have any query, doubt, you can ask me. I am here for next 10 minutes. So without hesitation, you can discuss with me. Okay. I just need to check whether our recording is going on or it is stopped or what happened. I also don't know. So recording is in progress. Can I